हेलो एवरीवन, वेलकम टू माय क्लास. माय सेल्फ अफशां, इंग्लिश टीचर एट अहलेबाद हाई स्कूल एंड जूनियर कॉलेज. सो टुडे वी विल गो विद द क्लास 9th इंग्लिश सिलेबस. ओके, इन आवर प्रीवियस क्लास वी हैव ऑलरेडी कंप्लीटेड द पार्ट ए ऑफ आवर फर्स्ट यूनिट, फर्स्ट थीम, दैट इज ह्यूमर, राइट? एंड द नेम ऑफ द लेसन वॉज द स्नेक एंड द मिरर. And now let us begin with our second part, part B, right, of the first unit, that is the duck and the kangaroo. So it is a poem. The first one was an essay, right? A prose part. Now coming to this one, this is a poem, the duck and the kangaroo. So this is a humorous poem in which there is a conversation between a duck and the kangaroo has been given. So there are only two characters in this poem. The first one is the duck and the second one is the kangaroo. Fine. Before beginning with the poem, let us have a look on the author's introduction, the poet's introduction. So the poet of this poem is Edward Lear. So the name of the poet is Edward Lear. He was born on 12th of May 1812 and he left the world on 29th of January 1888. Now we are in the 20th century, right? Now we are in 2020s. So he was the poet from 18th century, okay? He was a British artist, illustrator, author and poet, renowned today primarily for his literary nonsense. So he is not only an author but also a illustrator, artist and etc. in poetry and prose. In his childhood, he suffered from ill health. After a long decline in health, he died of heart disease. His principal areas of work as an artist were threefold, that is, as draughtsman employed to illustrate birds and animals. So he was famous for three of his major works. The first one was, he was the draughtsman employed to illustrate birds and mammals, fine, animals actually. And secondly, he was famous for making colored drawings during his journeys as an author, fine. So he was famous for the second thing, that is, he was an author, okay. And finally, he was also very famous for making colored drawings during his journeys. It means that he was a good artist, okay. Lear is principally known for his popular nonsense works rather than as a travel writer. These show a great ability to use with relish the sound of real and invented English words. The poem The Duck and the Kangaroo is a poem with a touch of light and humor. So what he is saying, he is only famous for his nonsense literary work. It means that his poems will be usually funny and humorous, fine. So in the same way, The Duck and the Kangaroo is also a humorous poem, fine. Now let us begin with our poem. Let us see what is there in this. As I have told you, this poem is a conversation between a duck and a kangaroo. So in this, the duck, let us see what it is saying. Said the duck to the kangaroo, "Good gracious, how you hop over the fields and the water too, as if you never would stop." So what the duck is saying here, good gracious, oh my God, how you are hopping. Hopping in the sense jumping. Hop means to jump. So here the duck is saying, oh my God, how you hop over the fields and the water too. It means that the kangaroo is able to hop over the fields as well as on the top of the water also. So the duck is praising its qualities actually, the kangaroo's qualities. And what it is saying, as if you never would stop. Okay, my life is a bore in this nasty pond and I long to go out in the world beyond. I wish I could hop like you, said the duck to the kangaroo. So what it is saying, my life is a bore in this nasty pond. Nasty means something that is bad, something we don't like. So the duck is saying, my life is limited to this nasty pond only, right? And I long to go out in the world beyond. Here long refers to desire, fine. So what it is saying, and I long to go out in the world beyond. I wish I could hop like you, said the duck to the kangaroo. So I wish I could also hop like you. I could also travel all over the world like you only, because my life is only limited to this nasty pond where I am living. I cannot go out of the water. But it is praising the qualities of kangaroo, right? It is saying that, oh my God, how you are able to hop over the fields as well as water too. I would also like to live in the order as if you are living, said the duck to the kangaroo. In the second stanza, Let us see what the duck is saying now. Please give me a ride on your back, said the duck to the kangaroo. I would sit quite still and say nothing but quack the whole of the day long through. So what it is saying now, the duck is requesting to the kangaroo, right? It is asking him to give a ride on his back, right? And it is saying, I would sit quite still. That it means that it is saying that it will not utter a single word, right? And nothing, and say nothing but only quack. What is the meaning of quack? Quack is the sound that is made by duck, right? So what it is saying, I will not say anything but only say quack, right? The whole of the day long through. So for the whole day, I will sit quiet on your back. So just give me a ride. And we will go to the D and Jelly Bolly. Over the land and over the sea, please take me a ride, Odu, said the duck to the kangaroo. So what it is saying here now, and we would go to the D and Jelly Bolly. What is the meaning of D and Jelly Bolly? These are only two imaginary places, imaginary words we can say, that are used by Edward Lear to make the poem beautiful, right? So he has selected these words as the name of the place, fine, as the names of the places. So what the duck is saying, and we would go to the D and Jelly Bolly, over the land and over the sea. So as we have discussed earlier, kangaroo hops over the fields as well as in the water, right? So now the duck is requesting that it will also like to go with the kangaroo, right? Over the land and over the sea. Please take me a ride, Odu, said the duck to the kangaroo. Now in the third stanza, the kangaroo is giving the reply. Let us see what he is saying. Said the kangaroo to the duck, this requires some little reflection. Perhaps on the whole it might bring me luck, and there seems but one objection. So what it is saying? Now the kangaroo is saying, everything is fine. I would also like to take you with me, but I need some reflection. Reflection here refers to thought. Some thought, right? There is one thought that is striking up in my mind. So what it is, and what the kangaroo is saying, perhaps on the whole it might bring me luck. I will be lucky to take you on a ride, right? But there is only one objection. Let us see what was that objection here, which is, if you will let me speak so bold, your feet are unpleasantly wet and cold, and would probably give me the rheumatism, said the kangaroo. So what it is saying here, what is objection? To be bold. The kangaroo is saying, if you allow me to speak boldly, right, if you will say that you will not mind, I will let you know the reason, right? And the reason is, your feet are unpleasantly wet and cold. What is the meaning of unpleasant? Unpleasant is something that will cause discomfort. So unpleasant is something that will cause discomfort. So what the kangaroo is saying here, your feet are unpleasantly wet and cold, and would probably give me the rheumatis, said the kangaroo, right? What is the meaning of rheumatis here? It is a poetic word actually for the word rheumatism. What is the meaning of rheumatism? It is a kind of disease in which there will be pain in joints, fine? So or else we can say, call it as a joint pain. So what the kangaroo is saying here, if I allow you to sit on my back, your unpleasant feet, right, that are very wet and cold, will cause me rheumatism, right? So that was the kangaroo's reply. Let us see to this what the duck has answered again. Said the duck, as I sat on the rocks, I have thought over that completely. And I bought 4 pairs of worsted socks which fit my web feet neatly. So what the duck replied now, when I was sitting on the rocks, right? And I too have the same thought that you said just now. I have also thought about my feet, unpleasant feet. And I have come up with a solution for this. And what was that solution? It was saying that I bought 4 pairs of worsted socks. What's the meaning of worsted socks? Woolen. Warm socks, right? I have bought a pair of worsted socks which fit my web feet neatly. So I have come up with a solution, and the solution is, I have bought a pair of socks that will fit my web feet neatly, right? And to keep out the cold, I have bought a cloak. So now it was all about the feet, right? And for the warmness, to keep out the cold, what it bought? It bought a cloak. Clock is nothing but a loose garment, fine, that will be usually sleeveless. It will act as an overcoat, right, to protect from heat or cold. Okay, so it is saying that to keep out the cold, I have bought a clock, and every day a cigar I will smoke, all to follow my own dear true love of a kangaroo. So what it is saying here, I have bought a clock also, and every day a cigar I will smoke to keep out the cold, to keep themselves warm. It is saying that I will also smoke a cigar every day, all to follow my own dear true love of kangaroo. So I am doing all this just to follow the true love of my kangaroo, right? It is saying that I am very much interested in going out with you. That is what the reason I am coming up with all these solutions, fine? On hearing the solutions given by the duck, now the kangaroo replied. Said the kangaroo, I am ready, all in the moonlight pale. What is the meaning of moonlight pale here? Pale is nothing but weak. So weak moonlight in the sense, in the darkness, at the night time. So what it is saying, all in the moonlight pale, but to balance me well, dear duck, sit steady and quiet at the end of my tail. So I am ready to take you for a ride, but what you have to do is, in order to balance well, sit steady. Steady in the sense, firmly. Fine. In order to balance yourself, sit firmly and quiet at the end of my tail. So away they went with a hop and a bound, and they hopped the whole world 3 times round. And was so happy, ahu, as the duck and the kangaroo. So what happened? After the duck balanced itself properly on the kangaroo's back, they went with a hop and a bound. You know the meaning of hop very well, right? And now coming to the bound, what is the meaning of bound? To run quickly with long steps. Fine. Bound is nothing but to run quickly with long steps. So they went with a hop and a bound, and they hopped the whole world 3 times round. So they traveled the whole world for 3 times. And who so happy? Oh, who? As the duck and the kangaroo. At last, what the poet is saying here, and who so happy? Oh, who? As the duck and the kangaroo. So they were very happy after traveling for the 3 times, after traveling the whole world for the 3 times. So this was all about the poem in which there is nothing. As we have discussed in the poet's introduction itself, he is famous for his nonsense literary works. It is also a kind of poem which doesn't have any sense in it, but it was humorous, right? It was little bit funny. So I hope you all have understood the poem. Let us continue in our next class with the 3rd humorous story. Thank you.